you.
Father Joss, are we ready na Father Joss?
Wala pa mo si Father.
No. Father, let us know if you are ready also.
Wait,
kadiyot sa sir. Prepare pa din si Father sa church.
Ako sa i-try sir, kadiyot, ginawa akong screen mo na ni Ron.
Sige,
sorry, wait. Wait. Kadiyot. How do I remove this? Okay. You can still see my screen, sir?
Yeah, kita na mo may.
Okay. Ako lang sa i-play para makaibaw ko mudo. Okay lang?
Yeah, then i-maximize ang screen.
Ah, okay.
Para di makita ang ubang other. Yeah, that's it. That's the maximum.
Aisa, kay nawa ako ang kuan lagi sir, sorry. Wait. Okay.
Father,
are we ready now?
Okay, Father.
Good.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. This is the fourth day of the Memorial Mass for our brother Adolfo Boy Larrazabal, offered by the Larrazabal family. Our main celebrant for tonight is none other than Reverend Father Joss Hugo of the Diocese of Queens and Brooklyn in New York. Father,
we offer this Mass for the eternal repose of the soul of our brother Adolfo. We begin this Mass in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
And with your spirit.
Jesus, let us acknowledge our sins and to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Adolfo, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. We now have the readings.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead. and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction.
But they are
in peace. For if before men, indeed, they be punished,
yet is their hope
full of immortality.
Chastised a little,
they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself.
As gold in the
furnace, he proved them.
And as sacrificial offerings,
he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones,
and his care is with his elect.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, your response is, I cry to you, O Lord. Repeat response.
I cry to you, O Lord.
My soul has hoped in the Lord. Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to my voice in supplication. Response.
I cry to you, O Lord.
If you, O Lord, mark iniquities, Lord, who can stand? But with you is forgiveness, that you may be revered.
Response.
I cry to you, O Lord.
I trust in the Lord, my soul trusts in his word. My soul waits for the Lord more than sentinels wait for the dawn. Response.
I cry to you, O Lord.
More than sentinels wait for the dawn, let Israel wait for the Lord, for with him is kindness, and with him is plenteous redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all their iniquities. Response.
I cry to you, O Lord.
Let us sing
the Alleluia.
Maya.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, what I have told you, that I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I'm going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, you do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening, my dear brothers and sisters, and also for those who are watching us in the Philippines or in another country, good morning.
Good morning.
On behalf of Guardian Angels Filipino community, I would like to extend my deepest sympathy to the family, friends, and relatives of our brother Adolfo. the reason why we are here today, we are connected via this virtual Mass, because we offer this Mass for our brother Adolfo. And we also remember their family. We also remember their friends. We also remember the relatives. I remember this story that there was a guy who visited the farm of his grandfather. And while they were having a coffee early in the morning, the father told his son that, look at the sky, you can see birds. Those birds in the sky, during the day, they fly about many different directions. But when evening comes, he said to his son, their wandering cease and they find a destination. They begin to fly towards something definite. They fly towards home. So my dear brothers and sisters, from that story, we will see that we're like the birds. We fly anywhere, in any direction, but we have a definite destination, and that is the eternal life, and that is heaven. I also remember this story about this man who wanted to visit his friend in the cemetery to bring flowers and to offer prayer. And he doesn't know about going there. He doesn't know about the direction. So he decided to use the GPS and he put the direction by the name of the cemetery. And then he was driving to the cemetery. And when he arrived, to his surprise, he was a little bit scared because the GPS says something about this. You have reached your final destination. Just imagine that if you are driving and then you are in front of this cemetery and then the GPS says something about that, of course, the tendency is for us to be scared. Every time we hear the word death, there's this fear. Human as we are, we have this fear of listening to that word death. And we don't even want to put that in our conversation, whether we are gatherings, we are with our friends, we don't want to mention that death. And if ever one of our members mentions something about that, we would say, can you just say some words about death? So we are afraid to hear the word death, and we are afraid of death. But if we really try to look at death, my dear brothers and sisters, this is not something to be scared of. Because this is our bridge towards eternal life, our final destination. We cannot reach heaven unless we die. So death serves as a bridge. That's how important this is for us to reach the final destination and to face our Creator. Even the Lord Jesus died for us to know that there will be an end to our journey here on earth and our final destination will be in heaven. Our brother Adolfo again reminded us of this reality that all of us will die. There's no excuses. All of us. As Christian, we should put this in our hearts and minds. And as Christian, we should not be afraid of the word death, and we should not be afraid of death, because this death will be our bridge to eternal life. But human as we are, of course, we always fear of death, because for us, sometimes we think that this is the life here on earth, and there's no more life after death. That's the reason why we take for granted the future. We take for granted about eternal life. We invest a lot of time to our present and we forget about the future. And that's the reason why if ever we hear the word death, we are scared because we are not prepared to face death. And we are afraid because we don't want to get away from what we have been living with. So we already attach to this kind of life. That's the reason why it's hard for us to detach if ever the Lord calls us again to heaven. So my dear brothers and sisters, this Mass is a reminder for all of us. And Adolfo was given to us by God to be an instrument to remind us of the reality. Adolfo, our brother, believed in eternal life. Our brother Adolfo believed in Jesus Christ. And he has this faith in our Lord. And that faith, my dear brothers and sisters, will be the one to help us, will be the one to save us. As I mentioned a while ago, the reason why we gather here today is to pray for him and also to pray for each one of us, that we may be able to absorb the reality of death in our lives, that we may be able to prepare while we are still here on earth, we prepare for the life in heaven. I always mention this for the funeral, that there's nothing wrong when it comes to investing something here on earth. We invest, we put money in the bank, we buy some houses, we buy some places for us to retire. There's nothing wrong about that. But the problem is, if we only focus on that, we forget about also investing something in the future, especially investing in our future home in the kingdom of God. And investing something for that, we all know that when we do good things to our brothers and sisters, that will be our investment in heaven. Every time we do good things to our brothers and sisters, if we do something good to them, that will serve as our investments in heaven. And if we do good things all the time, then we are assured that we will have a special place in heaven because we are following the will of God. And that is our very mission. Today is also the 6th death anniversary of my mom. So I know the feeling of losing a very important members in the family. For the Larrazabal family, you lost your dad, this very important member of the family. I also lost my mom. I feel the pain. I feel your pain. Because it's not easy to let go that what we love will be taken from us. And also, for the family, you will always hear these words. Sorry for your loss. This is also the very words that we hear every time we go to a funeral homes for the wake. Sorry for your loss. But we are talking here about physical loss. We are not talking here about spiritual loss. Yes, we lost Adolfo physically, but spiritually, we will never, never lose her. I remember the story about my mom, that every time we go places, she would always remind us that every time you reach your destination, make sure to inform us that you arrived safe and sound. I'm sure your mother has been doing this to you. Also, Adolfo has been doing this to you, because that's the role of the parents, to take care of the children. That's why when your children are away, you would always say, don't forget to text, to email, don't forget to message me or whatever means of information that would reach me to telling us that you are safe and sound. I asked my mom one time, Mom, why are you doing this to us? Well, if we are younger, yes, it's understandable, but we are all grown up. And she said to me, you know what? I'm your mother. Every time you and your sisters are away, and I didn't hear anything from you or from your sisters that you're safe and sound, I cannot sleep. I'm worried. But every time I hear words from you that you're safe and sound, I can sleep well. That's the mother. We cannot deny that. The reason why I share with you the story, because this is also the words that we will be asking, where is Adolfo now? Where is our brother? Where is our father? Adolfo has an answer for all of us today, especially to the children, to grandchildren. Adolfo will say, do not worry about me. I'm in good hands. I'm in the hands of God. So the very words itself, my dear brothers and sisters, is an assurance for all of us that he is in good hands. He has reached the final destination. And that faith that he has in his heart serves as a key to enter God's kingdom. And Adolfo is praying for us. Like what I mentioned, physically we lost her, but spiritually we will never lose her, him. Because he is with God. Every time we pray, we come in contact with the Lord, we come in contact with Adolfo because he is with God. Every time we attend the Holy Eucharist, we receive the body and blood of Christ, we come in contact with the Lord, we come in contact with our brother Adolfo because he is with God. So, my dear brothers and sisters, spiritually, he will always be with us. He will always guide us. He will always assure us of our prayers. So we will also pray for him and he will also pray for us. And Adolfo, again, is reminding all of us that soon, we never know, we will also be with him. We will also be with God. While we are still alive, let us happily fulfill the will that God has given for us, the will to follow him. And let us also happily fulfill the mission that God has given us to follow him and to bring him to people. If we do this, then, like what I mentioned a while ago, all the things that we do in accordance with the teachings of the Lord and all the good things that we do based on his commandments will be our investments in heaven. So may the brothers and sisters, we continue with this Holy Eucharist and we pray for each other that we may fulfill our role as followers of Jesus. And someday we would say in front of the Lord Jesus Christ, that mission accomplished. And the Lord will also say to us, if this is my beloved son, this is my beloved daughter in whom I am well pleased. Amen. Our prayers of the faithful, our grace that God comes to comfort us in our sorrow with his love, let us praise him in prayer as we ask him for mercy. For every petition, our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the church, that all may bear witness to the goodness of Christ, to lead us to eternal salvation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Adolfo, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he now be admitted into the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the family and friends of Adolfo, that they may continue to be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the family and friends of Adolfo that have died, may they all rest in eternal peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace, peace in the world and peace in our hearts, and for the safety of the men and women who serve the armed forces, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the intention we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God, our shelter, our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for Adolfo. Cleanse him of his sins and grant him the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
My liberty.
Pray, brethren, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you this sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Adolfo, we beseech your mercy that you did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that the saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled with the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, as your eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven, as with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts. You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At a time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. For us, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've healed us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Roberto, our Bishop, and his assistant bishops and all the clergy. Remember your servant Adolfo, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Colonsod, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
para ng pagpapalain. higit pa hintulot sa tukso. At yadya mo kami sa lahat ng masama.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Ngayon at magpakailanman, ngayon at magpakailanman.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer this sign of peace. My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant and strengthened by it, our brother Adolfo, we come to our eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. We shall have the prayer, the final commendation. Before we go our separate ways, with the state leave of our brother Adolfo, may our farewell express our affection for him, may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham and receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. An eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Adolfo, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed to human weakness, and may your goodness grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Adolfo, may the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. Before I give you the final blessing once again, on behalf of the Guardian Angel Church Filipino community, I would like to extend once again my deepest sympathy to the family, friends, and relatives of our brother Adolfo who are watching us through this virtual mass. I would also like to thank you all for joining us in offering this prayer to our brother. And also, I would like to thank the one who gave us the virtual music. Thank you so much. And again, see you, the Guardian Angel Filipino community. Again, see you virtually tomorrow for our Santo Niño Fiesta. Bing and Mar, do you have anything to say before I give?
Yeah, maraming salamat, Father, for celebrating the Mass with us tonight for the fourth day of the Novena Mass for Brother Adolfo Larrazabal. So in behalf of the family, maraming salamat, Father.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you all, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Closing song, May.
Give thanks to the Holy One, give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart, give thanks to the Holy One, give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ.
Give thanks.